Gamers are always looking to keep their systems up and running for as long as possible, and some of us even like to make our systems our own with a little customization, like stickers, paint jobs, or internal lighting for PCs. But what are some of those things that you should avoid like the plague if you're wanting to keep gaming in the future? Well, that's what we're going to go over today. What's up, guys? Chaos here. We're going to be looking at 10 bad things you should never, ever do to your console or PC. These things are not cheap. Everybody knows that. So you want to take care of them, even if you're trying to customize them. So these are things that you should watch out for. To start off this list, most of you know this, but if you don't, well, take heed to it. Running scratched discs. And I know discs are starting to become a thing of the past, but they're still here. And we're probably all guilty of, we're guilty of this. Everybody's guilty of this, whether you know it or not. Most gamers will take good care of their disc because of how much we care about our hobby and how clean we want to be with it. However, it is not uncommon for some things to get through the cracks, no pun intended here, and we end up trying to play a scratched disc. Now, let me be clear here and say that playing a scratched disc won't cause immediate problems, but if you play one continuously for a long period of time, it will eventually do some damage to your disc drive. Be sure to take good care of your disc if you still use them, and if a game you love really gets scratched, it might be time to replace it or just buy it digitally. At number 9, don't unplug your console during an update. One of the main things your console will tell you the most is to not turn it off while it's working on an update. I think we all know that these long updates can sometimes result in a bit of frustration, and it just we give up. We turn it off before it's actually done. Do not do this. There's a reason why your console adamantly tells you not to do this, and that's because it's a really bad thing if you turn it off in the middle of an update. A console's hardware is very streamlined for certain things, so while you may be able to turn off your computer during an update and you'll be okay, a console isn't exactly the same. Turning it off in the middle of an update can result in memory loss or even software damage, which is extremely difficult and sometimes even impossible to fix due to the architecture of most consoles. So just be patient, leave the room, let it do its update. At number 8, we have a very common misconception about consoles. It dates all the way back to the days of the Nintendo Entertainment System, and honestly, I don't know where it came from. Blowing in your cartridge. Something that most gamers know is that if you're using a cartridge-based console and it stops reading your cartridge, you just blow into it and it fixes it, right? Well, that's actually the complete opposite of what happens. Blowing into your console and your cartridges actually damages them more than helps them, and it's going to lead to your cartridges and your console dying quicker than they normally would. In fact, Nintendo has warned players about this in the instruction manual of games and consoles ever since the Super Nintendo day. So I really have no idea how it managed to become such a part of gaming culture, but it did. And if you're still using any cartridge-based consoles, which most people aren't, don't blow into them. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. At number 7, let cockroaches into your gaming system. This probably sounds like a joke to you, but I'm dead serious here, okay? Cockroaches getting into game consoles is a very, very big problem. According to an article posted by CNBC.com in April of last year, cockroaches are attracted to game consoles as a hiding spot due to them being nice and warm when the weather outside may be colder. Now, obviously, having some cockroaches inside your system will cause some damage to the hardware. So if you want to keep them out, be sure to keep your system off the ground and on a table or cabinet and clean it with compressed air. The warmness and the lack of good airflow will attract bugs to your system, so you just need to keep it off the ground where the bugs can't sense it and make sure that there is good airflow by cleaning it, and you should be fine. Bugs love electronics and they love to mess with the inside of them as well. At number 6, blocking the exhaust ports. One thing that people tend to forget about when it comes to game consoles and PCs is just how freaking hot they can get. GPUs and CPUs routinely get up over 60 degrees Celsius when they're running games, which is why you will always hear those fans going like crazy during long gaming sessions. but the fans aren't going to do any good if you have the exhaust ports on the console or the PC blocked. Make sure that your console ports are all uncovered and they have plenty of room at your current setup to breathe, and never block them. Or in the past, people would take consoles, they lay them on the carpet, they laid them on the vents where they couldn't get any air, couldn't get any circulation or flow, or they backed their computer right up to the wall. You need to keep it open. Your system needs to breathe. Cracking into the top five today, using third-party Switch docks. The Nintendo Switch quickly became one of the most popular gaming devices in the world after launching in early 2017. So naturally, when a console is super popular, plenty of third-party companies try to cash in with various accessories or controllers, and that's normally a decent thing. It's not that bad. However, a commonly reported problem with the third-party Switch docks is that they are often faulty and damaging to the console's touchscreen. Nintendo is super protective of their products, so finding a third-party company that actually has Nintendo's official blueprints for docks and makes good ones, well, that's difficult. Nintendo is known for being kind of lame with overpricing their accessories, but if you care about your console, if you care about your Switch, just bite the bullet and buy a dock from them. There are hundreds of stories around the net about third-party Switch docks absolutely ruining people's consoles. And I promise you, you're not going to get a refund from these third-party people, and they're not going to go buy you a new Switch when they ruin it. At number four, stacking things on top of your console. I know it can be really easy just to stack things on top of a console. I'm looking at my PlayStation 4 right now to make sure nothing's on top of it, but it's not a good idea unless you're stacking really light things like a controller or two on your system. You should probably just stick to finding a different place for them. Even if you aren't covering any of the exhaust ports like we talked about, putting a lot of weight on the console can warp the structure, which would eventually lead to some hardware problems and potentially breaking it all together. So unless the things you have on top of your console are super light and inconsequential, do not put things on top of your system, or you may pay the price for it somewhere down the line. And we all know, consoles are not cheap. At number three, and this one is super important, not preparing for a power surge. Now, power surges are a really big deal that a lot of people don't think about because of the fact that they're not common. Most of the time, a power surge isn't a big deal, and a lot of power strips come prepared for them just by shutting everything off. However, if you aren't taking special precautions for the event of a power surge, you're probably going to end up kissing your gaming system goodbye when one actually happens. If a power surge gets directly into your PC or console, they can do major damage, such as firing certain PC parts or permanently damaging the console. I just had this happen with my Elgato HD Pro in my PC and my Ethernet port, and I had it all on a protector. So just because you have a protector doesn't mean it's going to save it. It's always better to be safe than sorry, though. So always try to be prepared for a power surge, whether that means buying special plugs or power strips, or if it means unplugging your system altogether when it's a really bad storm. At number two, not monitoring your temps. This one is specific to those of you that like gaming PCs. Like I mentioned earlier, PC parts like the GPU and the CPU can get really, really hot during long gaming sessions, and the more demanding the game is, the hotter it's going to get. Now, this shouldn't really be a problem if your PC has good cooling and airflow, but you won't really know if that's the case if you aren't actually monitoring your temperatures. Many high-end computer cases have built-in thermometers for you to see how hot things are getting, and for those that don't have one of those cases, there are plenty of free programs that you can download that will monitor these things for you. So be sure to keep an eye on your temps and make sure your computer is getting enough airflow. Generally speaking, you want your CPU and GPU to be below 80 degrees Celsius for long periods of time to avoid damaging any internal components. And finally, unplugging the console while it's in standby mode. With the modern consoles and most PCs, there are two options when turning the machine off. Either you turn it off completely, or you put it in standby or sleep mode, which turns off the machine but keeps background programs running for a quicker startup, and it's also an ability to be able to download things while you're not being bothered. But something a lot of people forget is unplugging your console or PC while it's in standby mode can actually damage it due to possibly interrupting downloads or updates that you aren't aware that are going on. If you need to unplug your system, just turn it on out of standby mode and then turn it off completely. There's a hard reset for most systems. PlayStation 4, Xbox One, you hold it down for 5 to 7 seconds, it turns off completely. Don't just yank the cable out while it's sleeping, because you never know, it may not wake back up. You may have just interrupted something that could be potentially damaging to your console. It's always better to be safe than sorry. And there you go, guys. I hope this helped out. Those are 10 bad things you should never ever do to your console. Now, I've heard some horror stories of things that were way worse than what we talked about today, but just take care of your console. take care of your PC, or you'll end up having to shell out some big bucks because consoles and PCs, well, they're not getting any cheaper. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you found it informative, drop a like on the video, make sure you're subscribed, and turn on those notifications. I will see you pretty soon.